this climate justice, Jean-Monnet Center of Excellence, started in September 2020. It is a European initiative in the Jean-Monnet framework, financed for 3 years. And it is managed by University of Padova, especially the Department of Civil Environment, Architectural Engineering, with some activities inside this department we developed in the last year. It is the center has the roots on the research program Climate Change Territories Diversities, on the laboratory in G-Science and Role for Good, and in the International Master. I think it's very important to develop project on solid roots. One is, as I told, this long-lasting research project on climate change territories diversity. We worked between the Amazon and the Italy, between the Europe and the South America, about the issue of leaving fossil fuel under soil in a very integrated research with indigenous people, local people, challenging this very critical situation, looking for a just transition future. Then we have a long work on citizen science participatory GIS with a well-established laboratory on G-Science and Role for Good. We have an advanced master in which we manage issues related to technology and the technological sovereignty. And this international joint master degree on sustainable territorial development, climate change, cooperation, diversity. This is all the element and the basis of this center and creating connection also at international level and facilitating the preparation and the development of research and teaching activities. And then we have a cooperation with the Universidad Andina Simón Bolívar for a professional master on politics of climate change on biodiversity and ecosystem services. The center is not just in Padova. Padova is the coordinator of the center, but build this center in a long cooperation with other institutions, two African universities, the University of Ouagadougou, the University of Kudugu, and the Universidad Andina Simón Bolívar in Ecuador. And this helps us to have other vision of the world and also to connect with researchers working in critical issues. For example, what is about the climate change in the Sahel? What is about the climate change in the Amazon? Today, in the afternoon, we enter in these topics. And also the relation between dealing with research in climate justice and relation with social movement and active citizenship. The objective of Jean-Monnet Center is to work as a hub, exchanging and gathering scientific knowledge, practice and expertise in European policies on climate justice, but also international policies, and to make an implementation of these policies, not only European, but also a national and the local level. We can implement these policies only through dialogue and the creation of policies among civil society, research, and institution. We have three main objectives, one more related to develop innovative teaching, another more related to research and implementing research, and the other related to exchanging experience and especially creating tools to promote dialogue between academy and the world, the academy world, and especially the dynamic society. Society normally anticipate what happens in the world more than academy. This is typical of social science. In social science, society is the laboratory. It's not like physical science in which we create things in the laboratory and then we develop technology in the industry. In the social sciences, what happens is the society create things and then science arrive, reflect, support this creation. The main activities of the center is to develop interdisciplinary teaching activities related to geographic information science from one side and the energy transition scenarios related with the human rights and the biodiversity conservation. This is very important element. Europe is very biodiverse. Italy is very biodiverse in terms of cultural and ecological dimension. And we should take into consideration this value, the value of human rights in thinking in energy transition. Then the activity related to research and the important activity of networking and building a open dialogue. The teaching activities will start next year. We have course inside the degree in environmental engineering about climate change and adaptation on ecosystem and society. Then we have an online course, a MOOC, on climate change and adaptation. This course will be online, not only for the student, but for the wide public. And then another online courses on G-Science and climate justice. The research, key research topics will be to develop tools for geospatial intelligence to keep fossil fuel underground, and geospatial social intelligence. We have a market on business intelligence, but we create intelligence in everyday life of people, of society. And this intelligence should be able to manage transition and not be just market. Knowledge is not market, is a very important common good. And all this research is directed toward climate justice. We will focus on analyzing territories where there is a process of leaving fossil fuel under soil. We analyze and we keep a record of good practice, and we intend to prepare possible scenarios using the tools of geovisualization to imagine these alternative scenarios. Another important element of the center is dissemination and communication. We want to work with three languages. Clearly, we are Italian, but not all world speak Italian. And so we know there is a lot of world speaking English. But on the other side, there is a big part of our world speak Spanish. And so our activity will be in three languages, English, Spanish, and Italian. Clear, the ambitions can be bigger, but the resources are not so big. We cannot speak in every languages of the world, but we try to make what is possible. And we work with many tools, website, a geo-web platform, the use of MOOCs, the newsletter, social network events, a physical and online event. And then we are interested in maintaining and developing a networking with a permanent roundtable on climate justice. We have a plan of events. This is the first event. We have four more events planned during the life of the center, but the center will work also after the end of European financing. This is a good opportunity, but this is not just to develop the project for 3 years. The center has a long and strong roots and want to go behind the duration of the project. But we have many conferences planned. We are preparing this conference, so we have the possibility during this conference to build the roundtable and to invite more people and to share more experiences. A very important element of this program is the building of a permanent roundtable about climate justice. This will be a multi-actor and a multi-scale table, because we should deal with the problem of climate justice in Padova, in Italy, in Europe, in the world, but also in different local places, Ecuador, in the Sahel, and not in general in all the Sahel, but the specific village and the river basin, the complexity of scale of ecosystem and society. And so we start building this table with time, is not is the final result of the project, but we need time to know better people, to share experience, and to involve a representative of civil society at different level. In the afternoon, we have a first example of this topic dealing with experience from Padova and also from Latin America, public administration, the European institution. The products, the deliverable of this project will be a climate justice web portal. The web GIS, the web is open. The social network we started activating is total network. We are dealing, the social network already are working. The newsletter, the geoportal, today in the afternoon we have a presentation of this web GIS and geoportal with information about issue related to climate justice, leaving fossil fuel underground. Typical research activities like scientific article research project. We have we plan a final conference on climate justice and overcoming fossil fuel. We should prepare a book, but for us it's very important to work in this climate justice roundtable. Thanks for your patience.